So we come to this ATP, the energy currency of the cell. All activities inside a living cell need energy, which is available in the form of ATP as the immediate source. Hence, this chemical compound is described as energy currency of the cell. Its full form also you have to learn, adenosine triphosphate. Living organisms show two types of metabolic activities, anabolic and catabolic. Sometime difference between the two also being asked. Anabolic are constructive or biosynthetic process like photosynthesis, which consumes energy. Photosynthesis utilizes solar energy, na? So this is anabolic process. While catabolic are destructive or breaking down processes, it gives out energy for use by the organism. Example is respiration. Respiration, glucose is broken down into simpler substances. So respiration is a breaking down process by which a living cell oxidizes organic substances and release carbon dioxide, water and energy. Now this is the definition: catabolic process of releasing energy from glucose for carrying out life processes, that is called as respiration. It's a reaction also you have to learn. Now respiration versus burning. Sometimes respiration is compared with burning, such as burning of coal. Both liberate energy and both give the end product carbon dioxide and water. But this comparison is only superficial. The differences are like respiration is cellular process while burning is non-cellular process. Respiration occurs at body temperature while burning occurs at high temperature, ignition temperature. Respiration occurs in a series of chemical steps while burning occurs in a single step. It is carried by enzymes while burning is occurring under the influence of heat. Respiration is a biochemical process. This is physicochemical process. Respiration, energy is liberated as ATP and some heat, while in burning, all energy is liberated as heat and light. No light energy is produced in respiration, while in burning, light energy is produced. So these differences, which are 7 in number, you have to learn. Now, entire plant respires. You know, in all living beings, in higher organism also like us, respiration occurs in each and every cell. Internal respiration, that is cellular respiration. Likewise, in plants also, entire plant respires. Every part of the plant, such as leaves, stem, roots and the deepest cells placed in any region, respire. And oxygen in plants is obtained from the atmosphere through 3 inlets: stomata, lenticels and general surface of the root. Stomata, which are present in leaves, lenticels are present on the stem. These are the openings on stem which allow oxygen to enter, and general surface of the root means body of the root. Then plowing or tilling of soil. Why it is important? Because it creates tiny air spaces around soil particles and provides the source of oxygen for the roots. Waterlogged and compact soil does not have air spaces, which affect respiration of the roots. Then during daytime, due to photosynthesis, the leaves produce oxygen, some of which is used in respiration, and rest is diffused out. So carbon dioxide produced during respiration, the leaves, serves as a raw material for photosynthesis. At night, even the leaves obtain oxygen from the atmosphere and give out carbon dioxide. Hence, we should avoid sleeping under a tree at night. However, sleeping under a tree during hot midday is definitely good. Why? Because one gets oxygen due to photosynthesis and coolness due to transpiration. Now, important aspects they have asked about overall chemical equation of respiration pertaining to the following. So number of steps for glucose to break down into carbon dioxide and water. Many steps are there, but in chemical equation they have shown only one step. Many steps in general and two phases, glycolysis and Krebs cycle. Involvement of enzymes. Yes, enzymes are involved. Each and every breakdown step is governed by a special enzyme, and forms of energy liberated are ATP and heat. Then three ways in which respiration is different from burning that we can see from this table. Now three inlets for oxygen for respiration in plants. Those are stomata, lenticels and general surface of root. Now two kinds of respiration are there. One is aerobic and second one is anaerobic. So aerobic, free oxygen is used in respiration and there is complete oxidation of glucose with formation of carbon dioxide and water as end product. This is the reaction. This is glucose molecule. C6H12O6 plus 6O2 in presence of enzymes makes 6CO2 plus 6H2 plus 38 ATP. Respiration proceeds only when oxygen is available, and that is why it is called as aerobic or oxybiotic respiration. They have given that There are numerous steps in entire process, many steps, but shown by one reaction only.